Hi, it's Paul Anderson, and this is Disciplinary Core Idea LS4C. It's on adaptation. Remember, the last video we talked about was natural selection, which is differential reproductive success. In other words, each organism is made a little bit differently, and depending on how they do in their environment, they may survive and pass their genes on. What's interesting about natural selection is it's the only type of evolution that can eventually lead to adaptation. In other words, organisms that are better suited to their environment. But what is an adaptation? It's simply a trait. It could be anatomy, like a thumb. It could be behavior, what we do with that thumb. Or it could be the physiology inside of our arm that allows all of this to occur. But what essentially it does, it allows us to survive. So our opposable thumb, in other words, a thumb that works in opposition to all the other fingers, allows us to build sophisticated tools like computers and has really contributed to our success on the planet. And so that's what adaptations are. And so let me give you an example of this, one that scientists are really starting to understand. It's the story of the rock pocket mouse, and it lives in the southwest deserts, and it usually comes out at night, and it does that so it can avoid predators, but it does have certain predators at night. Those are called owls. And so they all kind of blend in with their desert, but there's a certain type of rock pocket mouse that has a mutation. It's called the MC1R gene, and what it does is it causes this dark coloration. So let's look at what rock pocket mice might look like in their natural environment. And so if we look at this habitat, you're going to see that that black mouse is going to step out, and we're going to be able to see it readily. But the other ones are going to blend in. In other words, we can't see them. And so that camouflage is going to be an adaptation. It's been selected for over time. Multiple genes have been selected to give them that brown color. But let's say I were to change the background and make it darker. Did you see all of these mice hiding before? Probably not, and that's because they blended in. And so could this ever happen? Could the ground ever turn from this brown color to this black color? Well, it actually does. There are volcanic flows, and so we have this basaltic lava that flows out in this area. It doesn't happen all the time, but it does happen enough to the point where once you have this black lava, all of those mice that used to blend in are going to show up, and they're going to be targeted. And over time, we could see that population change. And so that black could eventually become an adaptation. We'll get to that in just a second. Another example of one that we see all the time is antibiotic resistance in bacteria. And so bacteria will grow on this petri dish. It would be this brown. This is going to be billions of bacteria around the outside. But if we add antibiotics to that, so chemicals that kill those bacteria, then the bacteria aren't going to be able to grow wherever this disc of antibiotic is found. But what's going to happen in bacteria is there are going to be mutations constantly, over and over and over again. And occasionally, those are passed to other bacteria. And so usually these mutations that cause resistance to antibiotics will be found on a section of DNA called the plasmid. And so let's look at natural selection at play. This is all of the bacteria before the selective pressure occurs. And they each have different levels of resistance to the antibiotics, so low resistance to high resistance. And so if we apply an antibiotic to those bacteria, it's going to kill all of those with low resistance. And so after the selection, we're going to have a final population that is better evolved, or it's adapted to that environment. And so if we take one of these bacteria and apply those same antibiotics to it, we're going to find that in areas like this, it doesn't affect the bacteria at all. Sometimes it knocks them down a little bit, but in general, they're not being affected by a lot of these antibiotics. And so this is evolution. It's natural selection occurring. In this case, we have a physiological response. In other words, they're blocking the action of that antibiotic. And so all life on our planet, all of the beautiful diversity of life on our planet came through this slow mutational changes, which are then played against the environment. And so a polar bear looks wonderful. It blends in with the snow. It's really heavy, and so it can survive in that cold climate. It's perfectly adapted to that climate. Likewise, the dolphins have this beautiful streamline, and the giraffe has its really long neck. And so it's not like they're making those adaptations occurring. It's not like the giraffe is somehow stretching its neck. It's just that during a time of drought, giraffes that happen to have a slightly longer neck are going to do better. And what about polar bears right now? I mean, right now we're seeing increases in the global temperature. What's that going to do to the polar bears? Well, the ones that are really, really heavy are going to be overheated. And there's not going to be a need to go out on the ice pack and hunt seals if you can't get out on the ice pack. And so what we'll see is that some of those adaptations aren't helpful anymore. And so we'll probably see a change in characteristics or adaptations of polar bears over time. Maybe they'll become lighter. Maybe they'll start to hunt salmon like grizzly bear. And so we'll see that change over time. So what's the teaching progression? How do you introduce this to students? Well, you want to start in the lower elementary grades by talking about the requirements of life. And so if we have a rabbit like this, it's going to have certain characteristics that allow it to survive in its environment. But tell your students that if that environment changes, let's say it gets really, really hot or really, really cold, then they may not do as well. If we were to get a huge glacier move into an area, some of those rabbits that were perfectly adapted before are going to die. As we move into the upper elementary grades, we want to start talking about how the habitat and the life or the living organisms start to interact. And so let's go back to that rock pocket mouse again. So here's our habitat. We've got a bunch of mice that are perfectly adapted to this environment. But what happens if we have a change? What happens if we have this lava flow and all of a sudden the rock have this really dark appearance? Well, we've changed their habitat and now natural selection is going to occur. So imagine it's nighttime and this owl is now hunting these rock pocket mice. Which ones are going to show up more readily? It's going to be the light mice. And so over time, the owl is going to start to target them. And what's going to happen to this dark color? Well, that may become the adaptation. And we see this when scientists are looking in the deserts. They're finding that in areas where you have this dark basaltic rock, we're going to have more of these dark mice. And in areas where that's not present, we're going to see more of the light mice. As you move into middle school, you want to start to introduce this idea of speciation. Remember, speciation is the formation of a new species. And so imagine if we have two adjacent areas in a desert. One where they're really dark in color because they're perfectly adapted to that rock, and one where they're really, really light. What could eventually happen over time? Well, if there's enough change in their DNA, if there's enough change maybe in their mating strategies, those could eventually form new species. And this is the big thing that Darwin said, this idea that all life came from one common ancestor and all the diversity we have on our planet came through small changes in the environment and then species adapting to that. As we move into high school, we really want to talk about the steps of natural selection, and there's really four steps or four factors that species go through as they become better adapted to their environment. Number one is this idea of reproduction. We have to have enough of those organisms and the ability to make more and more of them. We also have to have variation in that population. So with these mice, it was going to be variation in their coat color. But in us, it might be variation in our behavior or in our height or even in the action of our thumb. What happens next is we have competition. In other words, there's going to be competition between those organisms. On a really dark area, then the light mice are going to be targeted and vice versa on a really dark or on a very light area. What eventually happens is the survivors will proliferate. In other words, they're going to do better, and that can eventually lead to a new population. Reproduction begins again, and this goes over and over and over again. And so adaptation is a process. It's how species become better adapted to their environment. The mechanism is natural selection, and I hope that was helpful.